Hello everyone, this is the second chapter of the Excelize tutorials, section 1. I will show you how to use the typical feature of the Excelize step-by-step in this chapter, and how to read and write Excel documents by functions provided by Excelize. In this section, you can learn how to set the cells value, how to set the styles for the Excels, add the table and the native graphic chart. I will use 15 Excelize functions in this section and made an example about student exam score. I will show you how to generate a report spreadsheet with Excelize by this example. Let's take a look at the goal of this section. There are some cells with data, formulas, merged cells, and some others in the student exam score workbook. Set the cells data first. In order to prepare the workbook for this example, we need to use 5 functions provided by Excelize. New file, new sheet, set sheet name, coordinates to cell name, set rows, and save as. Create a directory named 2.1 in the tutorial directory, and put the data and images resources in this directory. Open the Visual Studio Code Editor, create a source code with go extension named main.go. Declare the package name as main. Create the main function, and create a new workbook by new file function provided by Excelize. Then save the source code, open the terminal, run go mode init command creates a new module rooted in current directory, and run go mode tidy as any missing module requirements necessary to build the current module's packets and dependencies. Next, we rename the default worksheet name sheet1 to transcript. We need to use the setSheetName function. The first parameter of this function is the source worksheet name, and the second parameter can be used for specifying the target worksheet name. After renaming the worksheet, call the saveAs function to save the workbook named book1.xlsx, receiving and checking the error written by saveAs, and saving the source code. Run go run main.go command. It will generate the new workbook named book1.xlsx. Open it by Excel. There are blank worksheet named transcript as here. Okay, next set the cells value for the worksheet. Create a two-dimensional array with the interface data type. Copy the mock data I pre-prepared here, and then transform it into the two-dimensional array. Add the double quote for the literal cells value as string data type. Note that the header student exam score in the first row, the cells with values type midterm exam, core curriculum and science was in the merged cells, because only the cell value on the upper left corner will be applied in the merged range after cell merge. Other cells value in the merging range will be ignored, so we can set the cells value in null. After set value preparation, traverse two-dimensional array. Set sheet row requires start cell coordinates for each row, which can be calculated by join cell name function. Then using the setSheetRow function to set the cells value row by row. The first parameter is the worksheet name. The second parameter is the start cell coordinate of the row start cell. And the third parameter is the address of the array. Save the source code and run the program. Open the generated workbook in Excel. The cells value has been set correctly. Next, set the formula and merge the cells. Set the shared formula for the cells. The shared formula is stored only once in a cell. Set the formula in the cell range K4 to K9 shared by K4 as sum E4 to J4 to calculate every student's total score. Instead of set the formula for each cell in the range K4 to K9 in this way. Save the source code and run the program. Open the workbook with Excel. The formula has been set, and Excel calculates every formula result automatically. Then merge the cells on the worksheet. Create a variable merged cell range as a two-dimensional array. Declare for merged cell range. Traverse this two-dimensional array and call merge cell function with worksheet name merged cell range upper left and bottom right cells coordinate. Save the source code and run go run main.go command. Open the workbook. The cells has been merged. Next, let's set the styles for the cell and adjust the column width. You can see the cell's background color with the value student exam score is light blue, and the font was center alignment. Create a style like this by new style function. The function requires a parameter with style type. Specify font alignment in the alignments file. Set the horizontal file's value to center and set the fill file's value to the pattern. Specify the fill color with RGB format on color file. The new style function will be written at style ID. We store this style ID in the variable style1. This style ID can be used for cells, rows, and columns, receiving and checking the returned error, and then set cells style with the set style function. It requires worksheet name, upper left and bottom right cell coordinates of the cell range. Save the source code and run the program. Opened generated the workbook in Excel again. The cells style with value student exam score in the header row has been set correctly. Next, create center alignment style for the merged cells. Also use the new style function to create a style and create a variable style2 to store the style ID. Set the style for 3 merged cell ranges. Save the source code and run the program. Open the generated workbook. The style of the merged cell range has been set correctly. Adjust the width in columns D2K. Using the setColumnWidth function, change the column width. We set this 8 columns width to 14. Save the code and run the command. Reopen the workbook. The width of the column D2K has been changed. Next, I will show you how to add a table and a chart in the worksheet. First, add a table by addTable function. Create a table with worksheet name, table range, and table format properties. Specify table's name by table name field, and set the built-in style with table style field. This example used LightSim color, receiving and checking returned error. Save the code and run the program. Open the generated workbook, and the table has been created. And then create a chart by addChart function with worksheet name, upper left cell coordinates of the chart position, and chart format properties. Specify the chart type as column chart by type field, and specify chart reference cell data range by series file. Set the chart area size, offset, and position by format parameter. For example, scale the chart in horizontal direction to 1.3 times by x scale field. Receiving and checking the addChart function returns error. Save the code and run the program. Open the generated workbook. The exam score chart has been created. If we need to close the legend of the chart, set the legend as false in the chart format parameter. If we need to add the title for the chart, set the title field in the chart format parameter. And now, the transcript title has been added in the chart area. Next, insert an image into the workbook and set the view properties. Insert the image by addPicture function provided by Excelize. The first parameter of this function is the worksheet name. The second parameter is the upper left cell coordinates of the image position. And the third parameter is the path of the image file. The last optional parameter used for set the image format properties. Set the offset in horizontal direction by x offset field. And set offset in vertical direction by y offset field. And zoom out chart scale in 20%, receiving and checking the return error by addPicture function. Import GoPNG format image library. Then save the code and run the program. Open the workbook in Excel. The image has been inserted into the worksheet at the specified position. Next, we set the view properties for the worksheet by setSheetViewOptions function provided by Excelize. Specify with worksheet name, viewIndex, and view properties. Hide the grid line by set show grid line filed with false. Receiving and checking error return. Save the code and run the program. Open the generated workbook. The grid line has been closed. Next, create a pane for the worksheet. Freezing the first 3 rows. Set the pane by set panes function. The first parameter is worksheet name. The second parameter is the pane properties. Set the freeze field as true for freezing rows. Specify the Y split field to 3 for freezing first 3 rows. Receiving and checking error return. Save the code and run the program. XLTM, open the generated workbook in Excel. The first three rows of the workbook has been freezing. Okay, that's it for this video. If you like it, please give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please comment below. And welcome to subscribe and ring the bell so you can get notified anytime we release new content. Thanks for your watching, and thanks for your choosing Excelize.